Yo, this is Big Pokey, man. You tuned in to Sensei Sundays, episode 1.
I'm a H-Town nigga.
Yeah. Cut the mic up too, bang.
Y'all know who
it is. Yeah. What's my name, nigga?
I'm a H-Town nigga. Parking lot of the club, that's the playground, nigga. Get the city straight, nigga. Skates the interstate till I checkmate, nigga. It's that Big Podina. I eat shrimps and chemo before I rock your arena. Turn it upside down and I'ma sip it. Give me a kilo and I'ma sip it.
Yeah, man, it's going down. It's Donnie Houston, man. I'm sitting here right now with a real legend, man. You know what I'm saying? Big Pokey, the Big Po Dean, man. He's back with a brand new album, Sensei. First album in over 10 years, man. What's going down?
Hey, man. Glad to be here.
Yeah.
You know what I mean?
Yeah.
But, new project getting ready to drop, man. I'm excited about it. Memorial Day weekend, we're going for that, 28. So, yeah, you know, I'm just... I'm excited to get back out here, man, and, you know, do my thing.
Yeah, people been wanting to hear from me, man. So I was telling Sid, man, somebody ran up on me in the club about 2-3 weeks ago, like, hey, man, when that Pokey coming, man? I know he coming. I'm like, yeah, he coming, you know what I'm saying? It's coming, man.
Yeah, and you know what I mean? And that's, you know, that drive right there, man, was really, man, I do it for my fans, man. You know what I'm saying? And whether they don't really, might not know as much or know, man, you know, I really... fucks with them on how they fuck with me, man. You know what I'm saying? So I do that for them. You know what I mean? And, you know, I get a lot of love. I get a lot of people that, man, we've been waiting on the way I said, man, when it's coming. And that's, you know, every day. So, you know, it's here now.
Yeah. Man, what's been the thing, though, man? Because, I mean, it's been over 10 years, man. Like, what's been going on? What's been a decision to say, all right, now is the time? You know what I'm saying?
Man, just life, living. You know what I'm saying? Kids. Wife, you know, just a whole different, you know, just, you know, I'm hands on with my kids. A lot of times when I'm always doing music, but I'm never wasn't putting nothing out. You know what I mean? So I might be sitting on it, something I might lose, might not even, you know what I mean? But I stay recording, I do a lot of features and things of that nature. So I still eat, you know what I mean? But I just wasn't putting out no project. And then just sitting back, watching the game and seeing where it's going and you know, just watching and, you know, paying attention, seeing what's going on. So when I do decide to make my move, I make my move.
Yeah. What does it feel like now? Like, cause does this feel more so like this is another album, or is this more feeling like kind of like when you made your first one? Cause it's been so long, you know what I'm saying?
Both.
Yeah.
I'm torn between that, you know what I mean? And like you say, probably more so because of the time, you know what I'm saying, or whatever, from my last project. But it's still kind of always bring you back to the first time too, because my fans still fuck with me. You know what I'm saying? So that's what always keeps it kind of like brand new, and it never gets old to me. It never gets dull. A lot of people probably be like, man, I know you get tired of that or get tired of, but man, I really, I don't.
Hmm.
You know what I'm saying? I know what I signed up for. It comes to territory. That's like playing basketball and you whining about a foul. That shit don't happen.
Yeah. You know that's what you signed up for.
So, yeah, so I don't mind motherfuckers coming up. Hey, let me get a picture. Now, sometimes, maybe, depending on what's going on, just have some kind of, you know what I'm saying?
Read the room and see some kind of fan etiquette,
you know what I'm saying? But for the most part, I don't give a damn. I don't care where we at.
Hmm.
I'm going to take the pictures and, you know, things like that, and I don't mind.
Yeah. At this stage, is it more so about like, are you still trying to be the best rapper? Is that type of thing? Or it's like, I'm just still letting y'all know, I still got it. Like,
I don't put a lot of pressure on myself like that now. I'm just want to do good music and get in where I fit in. That's it.
Yeah.
I do me, do good music, you know, still here. See, that's one thing about this game, man. You know, a lot of people say, oh, you older, this, and this, and that. I don't mean that, man. This game here, man, longevity. As long as you know, can do it and deliver, man, you can do it.
And the thing, too, is like, you know, it's not like 10, 15 years ago, if a rapper was like in his 40s, it was like, oh, he's old. It's like, yeah, like your fans grew with you. So
exactly.
You got the people your age, you got people who was under them, who being raised on that now, right. You know what I'm saying?
And tied into that. if you a motherfucker that's in your 40s, but you really got something, see, you really got something. Mm. So, you know what I mean? A lot of times the substance behind your music gonna set itself.
Yeah, yeah. Mm-hmm. So talk about Sensei, man. I mean, you know, we got the project, man, 13 records, you know what I'm saying?
Right.
You know, some of the usual suspects on there, you know, you got your Lil Hoes and your, you know, but you got some younger guys in here, your D-Bandos, your right. XOs, you right. know what I'm saying? You got a chance to do some stuff with Trekkie Trill, we'll talk about it a little bit later.
Right.
Before he passed, man, but, you know, you dropped that Piped Up, man. And that really, because that came out probably, this was before the pandemic, but that came out and set the internet on fire, like, immediately.
Right, you know and that mean? Was, like I say, that was just me, you know what I'm saying, sticking him over, you know what I'm saying? Still putting some music together and, you know, putting it up. But at that time, I was pretty much putting forth a serious, conscious effort to really go ahead and put something out of
clogging up the pipeline. Word on the streets, they miss me since I put the mic down. Since I put the mic down. They say they miss me, nigga, since I put the mic down. Yeah, we clogging up the pipeline. Word on the streets, they miss me since I put the mic down. Now they pick the mic up. Tell them to cry, pull back, and he piped up. I'm from the planet where them apes at. If it wasn't for this music, I'd probably be trapping out of vape shop.
Who did the Sensei record, though, the actual title record?
Lee.
Mr. Lee did that?
Yeah, Lee.
No shit.
Yeah, Lee on that motherfucker a few times. Can't ain't no dropping nothing with that Lee. Yeah, they had Lee on there. Sensei, I actually did that motherfucker before, man, probably about 10 years ago.
No shit.
Yeah, man, and I never dropped it. And I kind of lost it in the shuffle. And I had another guy made it, the partner Dale had made it for me or whatever. You know, I always been a big fan. I like Big things and whatever. And that song, I used to always like that song Junior Mafia did for him. So I had put my tweak on it and I did it a while back. And then it's crazy how I was just thinking and ended up bringing that motherfucker up and ended up doing that motherfucker again and shit, that's the title track.
That just made me think, because like you said, Biggie, I mean, you had the hardest pit in the litter, which was nobody
seen my
kid, you know, with the Sensei.
And like I say, when I was doing it, I wasn't making it to be the title track, and she just felt like that. Same thing with Hardest Pit. When I did Hardest Pit, those were the last two songs I did. Tripping Me Out and Hardest Pit. Jaime did those. Shout out to Jaime. It felt like that. Like this wasn't planned, it just motherfucker worked and that's how the chip fell.
Heavyweight nigga. Skates the interstate till I checkmate, nigga. Know what I'm talking about?
Heavyweight nigga. City street nigga.
Okay.
So
I'm saying y'all like the
Brooklyn, Sugar, Cuban.
Wherever you
want to
do it.
Wherever you want to put it at.
Okay, I got it.
Wherever you want to put it at.
From the original part?
Yeah, we're going to bring some real shit. It's going to take us time to get to that. We know what we want to do. We just can't get there.
Yeah, I was just trying to do like a quick idea.
We know what we want to do. Okay.
Yeah. Come on, Tini, man.
Yeah.
Tini did that.
Well, table, man.
Tini, motherfucker, ain't it? That was nice right there. Sensei video, so y'all can be looking for that. It's coming. Title track. So we back here getting it, man. Behind the scenes, I'm a dog Chino Chase on the camera, man. Hey, we back here working.
Hey, what's up? It's your girl, Ronetta Spencer, and of course, I am here with the one and the only Sensei, the video shoot. So y'all be sure to tune in, because this is something you guys do not want to miss. First time.
Turn it upside down and under the sippy. Give me a key to it.